workaround or a way to appease these planets or do what you're not supposed to, don't do what you're not supposed to do, and do more in favor of what these planets are, the planet's behavior, right? So if you're doing something against that planet, whatever the karakatva is, then it might go against you. So I think those are the remedies.
Okay. Yeah, so all of them are kind of correct. Okay. Let me give you one more. Okay. Say, for example, you have say numbers like 2, 10, okay, and then okay, 2, 10, then 4, 8, 9, okay, and then say 2, 6, 12, something like this, right? So you have something like this, or I'll say 11 also. Okay. So you have some combinations like this. What happens? Mm-hmm. You see, and then this person is asking about career. What is your reading?
So it's not great.
It's not great. Why?
6, 8, 10.
6, 8?
12.
6, 8, 12. Sorry.
Mm. Yeah. 6, 8, 12. Correct. So the 6, 8, 12 gets connected. Because 6, 8, 12 is stronger than
2, 6, 10, 11.
2, 6, 10, 11. Right?
2, 6, 10, 11 is not connected as well.
Yeah.
They're not connected.
Not connected as well. Right? So you have 10 here, you have 11 here.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So this is green. Right? So, mm-hmm. But this is stronger because it is not connected. So now what we are trying to do is, using remedies, we are trying to reduce the negative effects of the 6, 8, 1. Okay. So
I see.
6, 8, 12 will be there. Mm-hmm. Okay. 6, 8, 12 will be there. Nobody can change it. But what we are trying to do is, we are trying to reduce the negative effects of that 6, 8, 12.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, but we'll go through all the pariharams. Alright, the pariharams or the remedies, what I am going to teach you will reduce the specific planet's negative effect. Okay, first we'll see all the list. Okay. Understood?
Yeah.
Okay, right. So now let's go back to what? Okay, what are all the remedies you think, or pariharams you think is there?
You said planets, so navagrahas.
Okay. Then?
Maybe related to Rashi or Nakshatra related.
Okay.
You look at the DBA of the time period.
Yeah, no. I'm not asking about that. Oh. I'm generally asking about what are all the different remedies available.
Remedies available. Okay, just for our knowledge, right?
Yeah. Based on your knowledge so far, you would have observed in your life, right? whether you go to some astrologer or watching some TV channel or news or people doing this, you know, all that.
I've even seen people not eating certain things on certain days. Or
okay, so that is fasting.
Chanting certain mantras, right? Being religious. What else? Some people suggest to wear some kind of stones. Offering to God or offering to people.
Doing some actions in certain way. Like, for example, if let's say my horoscope says that I have to become doctor, but I'm not, then that means I need to burn more energy doing something else.
Okay.
Something of that sort.
Okay. What else?
Changing direction of house. I've heard people do this, like they shifted their house.
Okay. Okay. That is Vastu.
Vastu, per Vastu.
Right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, right. Anything else?
Even getting married, I know it sounds crazy, but people are like, it's like, don't know, in Telugu, it's like, needi baaledu, so get better one.
Yeah. That's right. That's all you guys can think of.
Mm-hmm.
I think we will be talking like 30 plus remedies in this sessions.
Oops.
Okay, we'll go one by one, step by step. First, you all know people doing pujas, right? A general common puja for the god. That is the first remedy. Don't go by any precedence order. You know, I just wrote all the list. Okay, there is no precedence which one has higher, more powerful at all. I will tell you in the end which is more powerful. Okay, puja. Next, related to all these vratams, right? Especially the ladies will be doing a lot of vratams. Have you heard of this?
Yeah.
Right? So all those vratams, these are all like very generic, but specific, not specific thing, but a generic thing. Right? Raghu just said all religious things, right? That is a very big bucket. Homa. Have you heard of Homa?
Yeah.
Homa is very powerful.
Oh.
Okay. Homa is very, very powerful in doing it. But you have to do. I mean, you have to do in the sense you have to pick the right Homa for the right purpose and the correct person has to do.
Okay.
And you have to be in that process.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, you cannot give money to somebody, okay, go and do in my name. You have to be there.
Right.
Okay. I think this reminds me, I should have added one more item here. Now I remember why I did write. I will talk about it now, the end of this slide.
Is yajna and homa same thing?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yajna is even more at the highest.
Okay. But that's not a separate thing in the bucket?
It's all related, no? So now, normally yajna people won't do it. Only the kings, you know, those type of people will do.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay. People like KCR will do.
Okay.
I know you are asking because keeping him in mind. Okay. Yajna Sandal is not for normal people. Because it is very expensive, you have to do a lot bigger at a larger scale.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So only the kings, the rulers will do.
Mm-hmm.
The other ones, donations, offering donations. Dana. Charity. Dana. Okay. visiting pilgrimages. You would have seen some people say, oh, you go to this temple, this place and this temple, you know, like that. Pilgrimages.
Yeah.
Right? All that.
Mm.
Fasting. That you have said already. Right? Being fasting on a specific weekday for a specific purpose. So that is one.
Mm-hmm.
But the thing is, in the fasting will yield, it is basically mostly to cleanse your body.
Right.
Okay. To cleanse your body so that you become healthy.
Mm-hmm.
So in my opinion, it won't lead any astrological remedy. Okay.
I feel like thoughts become clearer when your body is clean.
Yeah. So that's all. Right. It's basically cleaning your body. So if people go and tell, hey, you fast weekly one day, hey, you know, all your body will become clean, you know, this thing nobody will do. Right? So they attach God to it, then fear to it, then people will do.
Yeah.
Right? That's all.
Yeah.
Healing. Nowadays, this Reiki has become very popular.
Yeah.
Right? People say that healing and all, I don't know. But that again, this also mostly deals with the body and mind. So,
yeah, I've tried it. It's really good.
Is it good? Okay.
Yeah, I didn't believe it. But when I tried it, I was astonished by it.
Okay. So what did you get like after Reiki healing?
So what is that, hyper or hypo, whichever makes your body thinner?
Mm-hmm.
I started to develop that thyroid.
Okay.
Because of lack of nutrients and all, like I was 17 years old and doctors are like, this is too early to start giving her medicines.
Okay.
Maybe try with food. So then I tried Reiki. After 3 sessions, I went and checked. No thyroid, all my HP count was good. Everything good. Got sorted by itself.
Right. Okay. Okay. Good. Perfect. They're very nice. Yeah. So basically, this again, my point is dealing with the body.
Yeah. You'll feel that universe energy actually going into your body. Very strange experience.
All right. But from a astrological perspective, what I mean by, in the predictive astrology perspective, that is not going to solve the problem. Like, you getting a job, you getting married.
Yeah. It's only so body, mind.
That's body, mind. So basically like fasting only.
Okay. Right.
Fasting only. You are cleaning your body, you are making your body clean and your thoughts clean so that at the end, you will get good thoughts, then or your decisions will be good. You will make right moves. So that is what it is. The next is name changing using numerology. You would have seen a lot of people, they change the spelling, they add some alphabets, you know, they spell the name little differently to suit the numerological value. Okay. The numerology is basically your date of birth. With the date of birth, you come with a total number and you add, there are the numbers assigned for each and every alphabet. And then you add your name, number, that number and your birthday numbers has to align. If it aligns, that means you will have good, you will get that energy of that planet. Okay. So then good things will start happening. So I have seen people who have, after changing it, it has been very successful for them. And so some people after changing it, it went the other way around. Okay. So one person, this example I'll tell everybody, positive person is change. Positive change, what happened to that person is Jayalalitha. Okay. So after she lost power in 1996, there were like 46 or 48 cases, corruption cases filed against her. Okay. Not 1, 2 or 10, 47 or 48. then she's very, she believes in astrology and all these things. So she went and then consulted somebody. That person added one A to her, Jayalalitha, THAA. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And after that, she got acquitted in all the cases. Only one case she got convicted.
Mm-hmm.
Because of that case only, even that case went up to Supreme Court. Supreme Court also gave the judgment. If she was alive, she would have gone to jail along with Sasikala.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, that's all. But from, if you think from her perspective, from 46 cases, let's forget about 48. 46 cases, she got convicted only in one case. That is a big change, right? That's a big improvement.
So she changed her name legally?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
You see the videos or the signature, what she made after 97 or 98.
Okay.
Okay. Say, then even if you look at politically also, right?
Mm-hmm.
She was literally dictating Vajpayee. She brought down Vajpayee's government in 98. Prithvi may not know, but Laguni might remember.
I'm like...
you might remember. So Vajpayee government was pulled down in 13 months.
Mm-hmm.
At 13 months, like it was like a big harassment for him.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So, I mean, forget about what is the political thing outside, right? You think from her perspective, she was calling the shots. She was not even a CM.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But controlling PM. Okay. Basically, she wanted to clear all her cases. That's all.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. Next is graphology.
So some people change not only the name, but their associated jersey numbers are right. The players, you know, a lot of Indian cricket players, they change their jersey.
Yeah, and correct.
Things change.
Okay. That also is aligning, right? So why they change that jersey number? It is also like a name only. They want to play. They want to associate that number with them.
Okay. So it's more than that. Name, more than name.
Yeah.
What about changing last name? I mean, forget men, at least women with, if
correct,
you go.
Correct. That is why one of you said after marriage, some people's life changed. That is like one of the remedy, right? So for a woman, when that last name changes, then your total name changes.
Okay.
Right. Say Prithvi, you have Prasad. Instead of Prithvi Prasad, it becomes,
something else.
Something, right? So whatever the name it comes, Prithvi Prasad, you add. Let's say it comes like 30. Okay.
Mm.
The 30, again, you bring it down to single digit. 3 plus 0, 3. Right?
Yeah.
You have to align. There's some, whatever that number it comes, say for example, let's assume 3 and it is, which is aligning very well. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So then let us assume you get 8. Okay. Or, or 6 or, you know, whatever. Some incompatible number. With the 3. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So then the problems will start.
Okay.
It'll can happen both ways.
Yeah. Okay. But isn't it like if you change your name, right? Like even Jayalalitha.
Mm-hmm.
If you get certain good things, you'll also get some bad things with it.
Yeah, but she doesn't care. No, she didn't care what the entire country thinks about her.
Right.
For her, she wanted to acquit or get acquitted in all her 46 cases. She told Vajpayee, you get to clear off all my cases.
Mm-hmm.
That's all.
Mm-hmm.
He gave some political reason and then pulled the government.
Mm-hmm.
And the entire country talked about what kind of a lady, you know, why all that. She didn't care at all.
Okay, so it's just perspective then.
Perspective.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. What is graphology?
So graphology is the technical name for handwriting analysis.
Oh.
Okay. So nowadays we are not writing much, but in those days earlier and now we used to write a lot. So our handwriting is our mind print. What okay. we think resembles in our handwriting.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. You know, by signature, your handwriting, everything. So by changing your handwriting, you are trying to change how you think. So
is
again,
it possible to change handwriting?
Yes, of course.
Okay.
Okay, some strokes, you know, all that can be changed.
Okay.
And say, for example, if somebody has very low in confidence.
Right.
Using handwriting, we can improve their confidence.
Oh, wow.
Okay.
So, if somebody is short-tempered, can you remove their temper using handwriting?
That is not, I don't think that is easy.
Okay.
Okay. So, that is a kind of, handwriting analysis used for a different purpose. Handwriting analysis used to read what people think. In fact, in US, FBI, CBI, they use handwriting analysis to narrow down or to identify the culprit. Some robbery happened, some murder happened. You know, they use this. You can see, okay, which person would have done that. Right? I'm going in one step ahead, and then with that, you try to change your mind. Okay. So again, this also is like a generic thing only. So that once your confidence builds up, then you can achieve your goals or whatever, you know, all that.
Okay. So some tools are just self-empowerment.
Yes.
Okay.
Vastu. We have talked about Vastu, right? So the Vastu plays a very vital role in our life, right? So again, this is a very good complement to our astrology, right? So your time is bad, then if you are living in a bad Vastu house, then your problems will compound or will go into multifold. Okay, so if your time is bad, and then if you are living in a good Vastu house, still you will have that problem, but that effect will be less.
Okay.
Okay. So I was doing one, I did Vastu here in the Bay Area. I told them to vacate that house. They bought it. You know, it's not good. I gave the remedies and all. I told them this is only a band-aid. You move out of this house as soon as possible. Okay? Don't live here long. So their kid had health issues. That kid is like 5-6 years old or something. I don't remember. Very small. Very young kid. Okay, that kid got diagnosed with cancer. I told them to vacate, but still, in spite of that, they didn't vacate. They had their own reasons for not doing it. Okay, they said, "Oh, when we bought this house, we consulted some Vastu, somebody in India. They said this is a very good house, all that, and that is a northeast facing house. You know, it is very good, all that." Okay, whatever it is. They didn't follow or whatever. And then a couple of months back, that kid's dad messaged me that a few months back, their kid passed away.
Oh.
Yeah.
It can be that, I guess?
Yeah. See, basically, Vastu will affect whose time period is bad.
Yeah.
See, your four people are living in the house.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, out of four, if one person's time is bad, that person only, the Vastu will affect even more. That's what I told you, right?
Right.
If it's already negative, bad Vastu will aggravate it.
Yeah.
So when I said you should vacate this house, they said yes. Because that girl had this problem, they have been like in a month, minimum 15 to 20 days that the girl, that child will be in the ER only.
Oh.
Okay. So like that. So they say, oh, we lived in Seattle. We went moved to Seattle. There the kid is good. The moment we come to this house, within few days, again, we have to run ER. And I told them, you are getting enough signals. Okay, I'm telling you, this is bad. Move out. They did. So that is how the effect of Vastu is.
Mm-hmm.
Meditation. Nowadays, this has become a very fancy term.
Yeah.
Everybody talks about meditation. Okay. It is good. I'm not denying it. Again, this is all cleaning your mind, your thought process.
Yeah. Can you do meditation, Dr. Prasad? And you also, Raghu? Can you actually do meditation?
Actually do meaning what?
Like when you start to meditate, it is told that you have to clear your thoughts. Can your thoughts actually be cleared?
That won't get cleared overnight, right?
Oh, okay.
Okay. If you are looking like you take some tablet and everything goes away like that, no. So this is a long process. Okay. You have to do for years.
Okay.
You have to do for years
mm-hmm.
to get to that stage.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. You know Rajinikanth, right? So
yeah.
What he does is, he says is, when he goes to this, all these events, functions and all, so yeah, people will be praising him. Right?
Yeah.
So that praise shouldn't get to his mind, to head,
mm-hmm.
right?
Mm-hmm.
So to do that, he says he will be doing meditation on that stage only. He will be just folding his fingers like this and then, close his eyes.
Mm-hmm.
You'll be listening what people are talking.
Mm-hmm.
But that meditation, he makes sure that doesn't get to his mind, head.
Oh.
Okay. See, think about fame of what Rajinikanth has and how much things are gone to his head. How yeah, people behave. Like one movie, two movie hit, the people became so arrogant. Right?
Mm-hmm.
So much yeah, of head weight.
Yeah.
Right? For a stature like him, he's very down to earth person.
Mm-hmm.
That is because of meditation.
Mm.
So it definitely works. Basically, okay, the thing is, your mind, you have to do it. It is not like a one-day thing or two-day thing.
Right.
You have to do daily for years.
Okay.
Yoga. This is another fancy term. It has become in the last few years, especially. Last 10 mm-hmm. years, maybe, right? Everybody yeah, talks about yoga. Again, this is again related to body. Meditation yeah, is for mind, yoga is for body.
No, yoga is for mind as well. It changes so much.
Yeah, definitely,
like, because I do yoga. If I'm having any mood, I want to become neutral. Just if I do 1 hour yoga, whatever mood, happy, sad, angry, whatever that is, it will become a reset.
Okay. Okay. So that is one. Yantra.
Yantra.
What is? Have you heard about this yantra?
Yeah, some kuja yantra or some different.
Okay. What is it that?
A shape looks like some celestial shape with some scriptures written on it on a
correct
metal.
Correct. So basically, there will be a metal sheet like copper. Usually, it is written in copper. Okay,
mm-hmm.
copper or silver like that. And some mantras will be written, some numbers will be written, you know, all that. Okay, you both understand, know Telugu, right? So we say tayattu, right? You know that a small thing that you tie to the neck, right? For the kids center, usually in the villages and places they give, right? So that is nothing but yantra.
Oh, so it's not just a plate-like looking thing.
Yeah, yeah. So basically, they take that plate, they do perform the respective rituals to energize that, and then, you know, can give it to you. So you tie. Okay, so that will help.
Okay.
This is straight away is a good remedy.
But so what is it used like?
For any purpose, right? So somebody want to get married, to get a job, and then somebody is like a very low in confidence, to improve the self-confidence. Somebody is scared, you know, all that. For everything, all that, you can use yantra. Okay. Next is tantra. What is tantra?
I know the name, but I don't know what is it.
I know what it is something from Shiva in a certain way. Like some rishis took it out. And there is a story. I just know that story, but I don't know what exactly it is.
Okay. Okay, you don't have to think so much. Tantra is nothing but all the tantric, you know, you say magic, right? You say black magic.
Yeah.
That is a tantra.
Is it a bad
thing? That falls under tantra. Let me put that way. Okay. That falls under tantra.
Is it a bad thing? Is tantra a bad thing?
No.
Okay.
But unfortunately, they're being used for bad things.
Okay.
Right? They're using for bad things. Unfortunately. Okay. 1 minute. I just want to show you something. Give me a minute.
Yeah. I watched somewhere recently. It should not be called as a black magic. It should be called as a white magic. What they say is... See, in every person, there is a spirit, right? Body is just the physical form.
Yeah.
So having that much of spiritual thing, you can, the spirit of the body can go from one person to another person. So you have to have so much of spirit to leave and then go to the other body and come back. And it's not normal. So
it's not black, it's white because of that?
No, people use for the bad purposes. That way, it's called the black magic. But it's not possible for everyone to do that.
So
the way you're saying, the way you're saying, right? Meditation. Can you forget about the thoughts? What you come?
Yeah.
From, right?
Yeah.
It's almost like that. When the body, when you die, the spirit leaves the body. Right? They are able to go to the other side and then come back. This person was talking about Sai Baba also. Sai Baba did that. And then they thought he died. And then he came back. So only certain people have that kind of caliber.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, on that same lines, people say Jesus also, right? He died on a Friday. He came back after 3 days.
Mm.
That's why they celebrate that Good Friday and Easter. So whatever. So the tantra is basically you are doing certain activities, certain tantric, certain way that you can influence some event.
Mm.
Okay. That event could be for good and could be for bad. Good is somebody like you want to get a job, get married. Yes, you can use this tantras, tantric methods, rituals.
Okay.
And you can do the same thing for bad thing also. You buy like killing people. Okay. That is the extreme thing. Black magic. That is what they do. So it is a very powerful method or one of the remedy. But unfortunately, nowadays, instead of using for good purpose, people are using it for bad purpose, for hurting people.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, Tantra works. But you have to do very correctly. The methods are very strict. You have to do on a specific day at specific time like that. Okay.
Okay.
The next is mantra. Chanting all the mantras, different mantras that we will be, that mantras are very, 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 very powerful. So you are instigating the planets or the respective god for you to help. Okay. So while we'll talk about more on the mantras in the next few pages. The other one is gemstones. Right? So what does gemstone do? So the gemstone is for 9 planets, specific planets. Right? So what it does is it energizes the planet. So whatever that planet is having in your horoscope, okay, if it has 2, 6, 10, 11, you wear a gemstone, double.
Oh.
You will get to double the 2, 6, 10, 11.
Benefit.
If you have a 6, 8, 12 in your horoscope and then you wear a gemstone, you will get double 6, 8, 12.
So this is for the lifetime or just that period?
Oh, lifetime.
Lifetime, okay.
Because the moment you start wearing it, then you are inducing that planet's energy into your body.
Okay, okay.
Okay, you are inducing the energy of the planets into your body through this gemstone.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so if it is negative, it becomes double negative. But unfortunately, a lot of astrologers, a lot of people think, oh, is this that planet is weak? Let us make that planet powerful by wearing a gemstone.
Mm.
So it is actually the other way around. That's why I tell a lot of people during consultation also, I tell, okay, if they're wearing, I ask them to remove those gemstones. People immediately said, no, sir, some astrologer guru, you know, whatever, Siddhanti, they have told me to wear, you know, this thing, I'm doing it. And then I simply tell them, okay, if you just trust me, remove that gemstone and ping me after 2 weeks or 1 month. Okay, then you see the result. Immediately after that time, they say, yes, I'm seeing difference. Irrespective of whether what DB is going. If that planet's DB is running, the effect will be even more.
Much more, yeah.
Much more.
Mm-hmm.
So basically, that is the power of gemstone. Okay, so out of all these, which are directly affects astrological remedies, you know, whatever we want to achieve, right? Vratam, Homa, okay, donations, visiting pilgrimages, numerology, okay, graphology, I won't say, it will help, Vastu, okay, then Yantra, Tantra, Mantra, Gemstones. Okay. These are all the remedies that was included in Umang Taneja's session.
Okay.